Tony, this is David Pegler here. I look at the European market for May the 17th, 2011. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Let me remind you, the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not alert service. I'm not going to make any direct trade recommendations during the course of a day. What I will do is conduct some live fundamental technical analysis. Hopefully, we can put together some decently profitable trade plans. Please remind, trading heavily leveraged, risky, so do not trade that hard-earned money until you have a track record of successfully using your broker's PlayPlay account. Okay, folks, well, I'd like to take a look at the Aussie dollar today. Really, all the dollar-related pairs look very similar. All right, we do have a little bit of Aussie news out today, so we can't get too crazy with the Aussie dollar here. We have to see where that leaves us for Asia. We've got the monetary policy meeting minutes, and I think that's actually fairly important. I'm not a fundamental guy, but I do respect news, and, you know, I have to look out for that and see where that leaves us from an inventory standpoint. But here's what I'm looking at, all right? I'll show you. I got you on the daily chart, and effectively now we've made a little lower high and lower low on a daily basis. This, guys, is the first real lower high and lower low scenario. Although we haven't broken support, I mean, you know, this support area here is still holding, okay. But this is a lower low, ready for the first time in forever, okay. And as a result, look at also one other thing. Yeah, look at these lower highs that have developed after a bounce of this area. You know, anytime you come down to an area of support a second time and then continue to make lower highs, it actually makes me fairly bearish here. Alright, so here's what I'm looking at. There's a couple of scenarios that I'm watching today, alright? One of them is this. If we just go to the hourly, alright, notice where late New York has taken us, alright? So we go up here, you know, we come back, we try to test the highs, she tries to go again, makes a lower high, and drops below that now. So it's actually broken a little bit of support. Now keep in mind, that's after making a triple bottom. Alright, so you got triple bottom, break of the highs, that should set up for at least one more of those, right? No. You know, in fact, we go up and make a lower high and then break the support. So, you know, I'm actually, given the daily, I know we got this daily support here at 105.23. I'm certainly not looking to get cavalier about trying to short into that. Alright, but I think that there's a few little scenarios here that we can entertain. Okay, we haven't quite got a new daily central yet, so we've got to keep an eye on that. But I think we can do a little something like this. All right, take a fib of this drop now all the way to the top. And you'll notice that the 50% of this drop here is right around 106, the psychological level, plus these previous swing highs. All right, so if I just stick a line there. All right, at sort of 105.90. So what I'd like to see is us go sort of retest that. And then we take a shot with a stop ready above sort of 106.20. Because I think as long as we're below 106, we can be bearisher, maybe even break little lows. All right, so something down, you know, we can target, obviously, first stop is the fib extension here of what is potentially at 382.50%, which should take us to 1382.1618, which takes us down to 104.90, which is a little 100 pip drop. That's not bad. That's better than a kick in the face. Alright, and the cool thing here is that we can just put a stop, like I said, above 20, sets up something with about 30 pips of risk for about 100 pip gain. Obviously, we're going to have to keep an eye on that news, which is coming out here. It's 2:30 Pacific. That news is coming out 6:30, so 4 hours time. Alright, yeah, we're going to have to keep an eye on that. But if we get up, you know, if we get up to this resistance point, with about 2 or 3 hours to spare before the news, there's nothing wrong, or a couple of hours at least, to the news, there's nothing wrong with taking that little short. I don't like to trade around news. It can make the technicals a little bit funky chicken. All right, but I don't mind this trade at all. And the cool thing here, it sets up a very nice little risk reward in alignment with the daily trend, in alignment with the 4-hour trend, coming off lower highs. You know, if we break lower, great. If we don't, we don't really lose a whole lot. All right, and said differently, if we break above 106.10 area, that's really going to confirm to me that this is a higher low, higher high hold. And if that's the case, I'm simply looking for that trade to go to sort of 106.70 or so. All right, in which case there's actually money to be made on the long side of that. But as long as we're below that 106.10, I'm bearish. All right, so that's ultimately what I'm looking out for. And then, you know, just on, I get a lot of questions on and remarks about, you know, what am I expecting longer term trend here? You know, basically what I'm looking for is a downside extension of this 4-hour of this daily drop. So call that a 786, predicts a 121.4 to 1382. So basically, I'm looking for price to jog down to around 103 and then try and head up again. You know, so a little sort of two-step system, you know, a little step down and then tries to bottom out a little bit and head up after that, I think. All right, so that's ultimately what I'm looking for on the slightly longer term. Hope you enjoyed this video, everybody. Good luck further today, and we'll chat to everybody later on. Take care.